Baby boomers, Gen X, or millennials, which generation is more likely to spend and save? Well, the answer might surprise you. Baby boomers. Financial planning expert Suzanna DeBacca joins us to talk about how cutting discretionary spending varies by age, generation, and offering some winning strategies. This kind of surprised me because when I think save, I think more, you know, older Americans, not necessarily those in their 20s to 30s.
Yes, we were kind of surprised to find out that baby boomers were actually cutting back on their spending less than in other generations. But of course, we see that baby boomers are very focused on retirement. So hopefully, they're already doing the saving they need in order to meet those goals.
Hey, Suzanna, what kind of discretionary expenses are Americans cutting back on the most?
Well, we just conducted the Ameriprise Financial Trade-Off Study in order to answer that question. We wanted to see whether these three generations, boomers, Xers, and millennials, were making the financial trade-offs they need to today in order to meet their lifestyle goals for tomorrow. And we saw across the board, in fact, Americans of all generations are cutting back. And the top three expenses that our respondents cited were eating out, entertainment, and clothing expenses.
Oh, very interesting. I read an article recently that said millennial generation, they're kind of shying away from maybe living part of the American dream where you just go out and you buy a home right away. Have you found that, or does that surprise you?
Well, we've seen research, and we know that millennials, as a whole, in general, tend to be burdened with more student loan debt than other generations.
Right.
And that may be delaying their ability or their desire to purchase homes. But in this study, we actually saw that millennials have some consumer debt as well. So if millennials want to be able to meet financial goals like purchasing a home or to sock money away for the future, it's going to be very important for them to start making some trade-offs in their lifestyle so that they can actually achieve what they'd want down the road.
What are some discretionary expenses that maybe are easier to cut out, easier on, you know, us as consumers to cut out than some others?
Well, at the top three expenses that people had cited, the eating out, entertainment, or clothing expenses, seem to be things that people view as very discretionary and are able to cut back. Some other things that we saw that sort of rose to the top were gym expenses, personal grooming, even expensive food items, food, wine, organic foods, things like that. So I think those are places that it's kind of a no-brainer that you can look at. How can you cut back a little bit?
All right. Well, Suzanna DeBacca, very eye-opening. Thank you so much for the work you do and interesting information this morning.